G'day and welcome back to 10 Targets Detecting. My name's Camille and I'm on a private permission with some Rose here. That's right, look who's here joining me today. It's very, very quiet. I've got the Manticore M8 COIL in this trashy site and I'm going to see what I can find. Come along for the ride. Let's show you some settings real quick. Ground balance. No, let's just start from down here. So, volume, I'm not using my headphones so you can hear everything. 22 is where I'm at. Don't like it too noisy. Don't want to disturb those roos. All terrain general. Noise cancel, the last thing I do for my ground here. Might be different where you are. I like zero. Recovery speed. If you're influenced by other detectors you've used, where, for example, with the NOx 800, you've had to pump that recovery speed right up in these trashy areas, the Manticore is not like that. The Manticore can still do great target separation around the 5 and the 6. Discrimination pattern. Or metal. That's what we're gonna do. Did I select it? Let's go back. All metals open. I use soft keys for my, the last thing I do is my noise cancel. I was quite high with my sensitivity. I didn't need to change that. We're rotating through, we're locking on the 8. So I'm quite high. That's powerful. There's no EMIs quite as, let's go. Well, this looks good. I love this sort of depth. I love the 3 bars. Definitely. 86, 90. When you've got such a high sensitivity, I'm not getting the most stable target IDs, but I deal with that. Yeah, right in here. Right in. So the powerful Manticore, right? So powerful. It's 3 bars. Even with a small coil. Let's see. Oh, can you believe it? Stand by, I've got to get my... Look what I did, I didn't put my glove on. Okay, gloves on. We got to here, didn't we? Yeah. I got so excited. After I filmed my intro, I just started detecting. I didn't even think twice about putting on the... Oh, I wish it was a toy car. That's what usually I used to find really close to these sort of trees. And now that it got slashed here, maybe we got to move. Maybe they went closer into the tree. Maybe not. Maybe it's just a bit of rubbish, bit of lead, or not. Or this. Oh, part of a padlock. Is it? Yes. It is. See the lock? One of those old Jackson locks or something. Very cool. If only there was more to it. Let's see if there's any more. No, bit of a broken padlock. That's cool. I like it. Let's go. Oh, I should have turned on for a live dig. Check it out. It's a halfpenny. It's a halfpenny. It's a kangaroo halfpenny. Oh, very, very good sniper coil. I've seriously gone over this ground before. Like, I know I've worked close to this tree. I've gone, there's a bit of an incline and I want to get in here before. Oh my God, it's all starting to grow again. Then I won't be able to swing so much. Anyway, we got ourselves a halfpenny. We'll keep going. Coin like tone, right near the halfpenny. Oh gosh, you don't want it better any more than that. 2 bars. I can't get it. Oh, it was a nice spot. It was like around this there. 3 bars. I love it. In here. We'll do it together. If we can get in. Very close to the halfpenny. So, like this foot. This foot's where the halfpenny was. So, that's all I gotta say. That close, sounded amazing, and now I've jinxed myself and it's gonna be a bottle cap. Ta-da! I saw it. Here she is. It's a kangaroo halfpenny. Kangaroo penny. near the other kangaroo halfpenny. 1940, maybe 1944. Look at it. Interesting. Sort of wet soil. Well, sort of early in the morning, isn't it? Anyway, we will keep on going. Great start, sniper coil, keep it up. This was a 98 target ID. I didn't turn you on because I've never found anything amazing at 98. It's just too high a target ID. And, oh my God, it's a plug. See the plug, that's it coming at 98. Well, there you go. Interesting, but still not too amazing. We'll keep going. Guys, it was sort of 82-ish. And there's glass, right? And I thought it was a hint of silver. Now I'm not so sure. Please be silver. Imagine. Negative. Can't see exactly what it is though. Just another. One day I want to go like that and just see something different than a kangaroo bedding. There's just hundreds of these. Literally hundreds here. Another kangaroo penny. That came in different, wouldn't it? 89. They just ring up a bit different, and I think that's to do with the manticore's high sensitivity and less stable target ID, maybe. Anyway, moving on. After not doing those live, those last ones live, we've got to do a live. Now, this is a bit sketchy, but I'm down to sketchy. I've been here that many times. I've got to dig all the sketchies now, the one-way signals, the clip-clops, because I may have left it previously. It sounds pretty good that way. Interesting line that could be indicated can. Only way to know is if you dig it. Go a bit wide because I love this site for all the other things that are in the hold. Yeah. That are non-metal. Yeah. Such as marbles, you know, bottle stoppers. Yeah, I mean, I love bottles too, but I don't even crunch a bottle doing that to it. But yeah, I should take you guys to the bottle dump area. I'll show you that. It's pretty cool. I've been through it. Actually found a florin there. One of the very few florins I have found here. Well, there you go. See? Rubbish. Never mind. We move on. Okay, one step from that bottle cap. Is this? Sounds coin-like to me. 70-something. Is it both ways? Three bars. Let's do this one together and see if there's any more luck in the last bottle cap. Yeah. Yeah. Three bars is good. I actually came for a hunt here and I did not bring the camera. I like to go for a hunt sometimes without it. And I actually found a couple of small silvers right, you know, in this vicinity where I'm hunting right now. So that's when I came back for this hunt. Starting again in the same area, going over some old ground in case some small silvers wanted to show themselves. Not this time. Not a small silver, but it could have been, right? It's a small 0.01 cent piece. Let's go. Murphy's Law. When I put my two gloves on, because I usually, when I get my camera out, look, one hand is no gloves, and the other hand is gloved for digging, and I can see there. Here was the impression. Just here. What coin do you reckon it's going to be? Oh, there it is. Look at that. Oh, kangaroo halfpenny. For a moment, I keep seeing silver. Obviously, it's so coppery, but why did I just... I was just like, oh my... No, I thought it might have been a shilling for a second. Nope. Kangaroo penny. Halfpenny. I mean, we keep going. I've had to toggle between some discrimination. Oh, is that an imprint? Let's swap hands. Some discrimination and all metal because this area, there's just so much going on. It's just too confusing. There's a bit of glass and I don't know if it's coin or not. It is a coin. Oh God, it just dropped. I thought that was going to be some solid ground, but no, it's not. My God, this area. Still more coins. When is this gonna end? I found hundreds of pre-decimal coins at this site over a number of years, and then so many hunts, and I'm still finding big copper coins, small silver coins, and you know, parts of padlocks. It's pretty cool, right? What an awesome site, just me and the ruse. So good. I don't know if this is trash or treasure. Just next to that was that penny. Then right next to it, and that's why it was so clip clop. I didn't actually turn you on for that last penny, because it was sketch. It was so sketch, but I couldn't help but dig it. There was so much going on around it, I had to put some discrimination back on. I've got to here, it's a 50 something. I think it's trash, but you never know. Thought maybe a badge. No, okay. So this is 50 something, one of those eyelidy, one of those, what are these called? You know. Anyway, so there's so much going on. I'm going to actually show you. Let me swing with you and show you what's going on. Show you what it's like. So there's this beep, beep, beep. Rubbish. You can see it with your eyeball. And you just wait. Gotta concentrate, right? I can't talk and concentrate. And you wait for a ping. Then I usually would turn you on by then. And we say, oh, let's do a live dig, right? But it takes me, you know, that swing, 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 concentrate, concentrate in that all metal mode. It is a constant listening. Two bars at 80 something. Hello, little mantee. Better look after you. Move you over there. In this area where I've been digging, look, charcoal. There's just so much rubbish. I reckon this was a bit of a dump. And there's just so many bottle caps, but not in this hole. In this hole, there's a, see, in amongst the rubbish. Snipers it. Let's do it again, eh? Let's get back up and have a swing together and see if we can ping one together. All right, this is what I deal with, right? We get up and we're like this. Okay, it's sort of stable enough to keep swinging. If not, I'll just use my soft key and it doesn't hurt. Mid-session to another noise cancel. I could be, you want to find an area though that's no metal. That's okay. -7. We settled, we're in all metal. And what I'm listening for, good tones. You have to just go a bit slow. Hang on. I don't mind that. You can see a bit of ferrous. No, it's not holding. Hang on. Well, listen. Nice, right? Up high, though. When you swing up high and it registers, it's suggestive that it's like a bottle cap or some sort of rubbish. When you swing up high and it's two bars and doesn't register, we're probably coins. See that? Two bars, I shouldn't be able to reach that. We're going to get some trash, I reckon. Let's just put our little shovel that we left back here. We'll move our pinpointer gently and reveal the rubbish. Ugh. Prove me wrong and be a penny or a coin. Oh my God, you proved me wrong, you. Imprint penny. Oh my goodness, it swung up high. That rule is only a guide, it's not a rule. 1964, that's the last year that pre-decimal, these copper coins were minted. The last year of these kangaroo pennies was 1964, and they were out of circulation. After 1966, we had our decimal currency. What a significant year. Oh my goodness, we did that together. Okay, let's do another one together. I'm so sorry, guys. After that kangaroo penny, the videoing just was a bit mucked up by me, of course. But during this time, right now, I find another kangaroo penny in that same area and we're onto something. Guys, I think we've got a spill. Because this is, that's where I pulled out penny and the penny on top. And look, that's why that swing up high technique. You're joking. Okay, let's just be a little bit careful. I don't want to hit anything. Yeah, that's exactly where I was. That was exactly where I just was. And I just pulled out that one there. Oh, 1960 something. I'm just going to loosen it and lift from under. Look, lift from under. Reveal yourself. I don't need two hands. Let's just do another one. Oh, this is so much fun, isn't it? When you just find a lot. I haven't actually found too much rubbish. I've cleared so much rubbish out of this site. Oh, is that it? Nope. Clear the rubbish. Goodies reveal themselves. Just in here somewhere. Yep. Oh, maybe this is what it was on top of. Oh my God. We'll have a look when we clear it all, when we look at everything later. This to me looks like a weird colour, like maybe there was something on there. Maybe they'll all fit on top of each other. Who knows? Anyway, into the pouch. It's another kangaroo penny. And the year, 1950. Far out. All right, swinging together is proving to be very successful. I'm not even joking. This is the spot. Ready? It's just still going. Must have been like, I haven't had a good spill for a while. I don't even know where it was exactly. I have to use my pinpointer. 89. So we're looking at just a penny spill, aren't we? Yep, we are. And they're all got this. They must have been. Oh, that's the one that matches the other one. Oh, this is all making a bit more sense. See how there's like that. You know, when you find coins on top of each other, they've made a bit of a mark. See, there's discoloration. All right. Actually, I'm not even going to turn you off. I'm pretty sure that's got to be the last one because it wasn't. That explains that up high technique. Yep. Let's just swing from here. Don't want to turn away. See how it's bleeding into the ferris? Oh, I don't know if you can see, it's a bit glary. I just don't like it. I like that. There's so much rubbish. I just have to move my shoulder. But you have to just be a little bit selective. We're just so close to that other penny spill. I haven't actually covered it all up. Let's just do this. Here's my mark. Ugh. You'll see, there's just so much rubbish. You know, if you've been watching my other videos at this site, there's just, look, every step I could honestly dig a hole. Oh my goodness, what's this? Oh, from a car. Is it? What does it say, Calais or something? Or someone will know. Someone always knows these things. They tell me. Because sometimes I find those. I forget the name of them now. Anyway, I reckon this is some decal, something off a car. What was I going to say? Every step I could dig a hole. Honestly, there's just that many targets everywhere. And I don't even mind digging this. The rubbish. It's just fun. Or a Corolla. Anyway, let's move on. So much fun together. We'd be out of our luck. Okay, this was just that Corolla-y thing. Okay, so the pennies. Ba-ba. Step back. And then here. Was that clip-clop sketchy? But see how it snipers it? There's this here. It's ferris. It's really hard to see, but there's red popping up, which is indicating ferris, and then boom, there's so much even under this little coil, right? There's some stuff there, there's some splodge. That's what I call the sniper. Could our luck, oh my god, it's both ways. Could our luck run out? Ooh. When I'm holding the camera swinging, I leave my shovel a little bit. This is so much fun. I'm having so much fun. Oh gosh, I'm acting a bit crazy now, aren't I? Just so much fun digging and finding cool stuff. It might be trash, other people, but it is absolute treasure to me. I just love this hobby. Trash or treasure, something there and something in here. I can see how much trash, there was trash down there, and I've got to be careful with my pinpointer, could have scratched it. 1962, it is a kangaroo of penny. You know what, together we better have a swing. Far out, this little spot I've worked, and this is the thing, I've been here from that tree here, and I didn't sort of detect there because I hate the resistance. I'm done there. There was something, nothing. See how there sort of wants to be, but it's not. That's like some yucky screwy thing. Anyway, okay, I'm going to flick this over and stomp it in, and then we'll go again. Nope. Okay, let's do a 46. 49, 48, it's round on the center line. Up high. Registers, unfortunately. Just in here. Oh, there's another beep. Just there. Caught my attention. Caught in here. Yeah. Let's have one quick swing again. Oh god, just there. Once wants me to dig there, doesn't it? Let's just do this quickly. Feeling it's going to be like a ring pull. Part of a bit of trash. That's all we have to do here. Don't worry, this place is just a matter of digging a hole, filling it in. It is so amazing to have a site where you can just do that. It's not. Okay, so rubbish there. You just have to do, you know, this. And with one hand with filming, this is pretty good. This is all that's required of me, stomping it back in and covering her back up. I've got weeds and thorns and rabbits and, let me just put my rubbish, and I've got so much. See, pretty good. It's just an area that, that was that. It is, there's some plans in place. No, see, don't like it. Don't like it, not gonna waste time. I pay money for this 2D screen, I'm gonna use it. The proposals for townhouses and other development here is, has been so many objections. But the reality, I'm not. Look, I know you want me to dig it, but it's trash. But prove me wrong again. The objections don't really matter when the grass is so long and I just honestly can't detect in this. Oh, look, long, I just can't get right in there. I just can't. There's only a certain height before I don't detect any resistance. I don't like the hard work. See, told ya, it's just trash. Okay, I'm gonna turn it off and you can join me on the next. Guys, this is as far as I got, and look, I when I put my shovel in, I could hear crunch, right? And I think I broke off glass. So, excuse me, I was being reckless. And then I've got to hear, I think it's a truck. Yes, it is, it's a toy. Be gentle with these things, the wheels fall off. Very cool. Now we got ourselves a toy. I reckon he's old too. I don't know if this is more of the same, no, truck or just rubbish. Or asbestos. Yes, could be. Let's get in to the side. It was a sketchy signal, but it was one I have to dig. When you've been back this many times, you dig these. Ah, asbestos. What is it? Oh, it's lead. Jesus, don't these ring up nice? Every now and then I think, oh, when I, these, it's this round bit here, the washer bit. every now and then I think, oh, it might be a coin on there. You never know. They made it a makeshift washer. Anyway, talking too much. Let's go. So, guys, this has been my morning from that bit of a padlock to non-stop digging with a very minimal amount of rubbish. Want to do the swing high technique? Doesn't register a few inches, then starts to register. Only a guide anyway, as I saw. Never gonna take that as an absolute because I thought I was digging a bottle cap before. Oh goodness. And it was a penny. But what a good morning, huh? Good morning. That is not good for my shovel. That's okay. I've learned how to sharpen it. That's right, I'm very capable. If I say so myself, I've learned about... Oh. Let's ground balance this again. Hold it towards the ground, away from metal. Wait for the click. Oh! We did it together. Now, it's got that funny discoloration. Let's swing again. It's a kangaroo penny. Put it safely in the pouch. You ever dropped anything? Oh my God, you know what I've lost at this particular site? A lead. Like, ship. That's right, a toy. That's it. Just shows you. There's just so much stuff here. Let's flip this over. Let's keep swimming. Swinging. Yes, I had a, I found a ship. It was about this big, really heavy. And I actually, my bag was so full, I back in the day of finding so much rubbish. And anyway, I put some stuff down and I just, somewhere between detecting and getting back to the car, I lost it. Okay, let's move on. Never mind, one day I might find it again. So I just keep the camera rolling and do live digs. So here was that 3 bar down the 80 something. Now where are you? Nice, right? Swing up high. Doesn't register. Due for a silver. I've worked hard. I've worked hard this morning. Silver, reveal yourself. Oh, that's so nice. You can get in like that. And then every now and then you get a bit of a jarring if there's a brick, a tile, you know, a sheet of metal, something like that that's just been, you know, buried. Oh, every hole. And that's why I still look in every hole, not just for, you know, oh God, of course. What do you reckon when there's so much glass? Do you remember that time I found a bottle cap and it had a marble in it? Right? Anyone who remembers, it was so cool moment. It was a cool moment. I was like, oh my God, there's a bottle cap. Wait, there's a marble. I think we could be deeper. The only way to really know is to have a swing sometimes. Disturbed it anyway, don't worry. So much going on. Let me take horseshoe off. See, when you disturb something, I think it's further down. If I can't do it one hand in the next bit, I'll let you know what it is. Just there. Because there's glass, I just gotta be careful. Don't wanna get an injury, put me off detecting. Ugh. That's right, it's called the back dig. That's right, the fancy back dig. Hope you're all looking after yourselves when you guys go detecting. My knees are the first thing to go at the moment. I've looked after my hands, my arms. I don't like to work too much in resistance. And as we thought, oh, but it's one of these cool ones that I find here. Coca-Cola, Canberra. Oh, I wonder where I'm detecting. Interesting. Okay. Trash, but interesting. Find these a lot. They give a great signal. It's part of that part of a ruler, isn't it? What do they call it? You know, it's an inch. Inches measurement. Oh. Anyway, good signal.
Let's keep going.
Did every door have one of these? Because I have literally found so many of these here. Jesus, did every single freaking gate, our door or whatever, have this sort of latch? So many. Anyway, guess what it's time for? It's time for a little break. I show you my holes as I find them. The first blah, 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 as it goes. And then that's how it gets edited. It all gets just put together, compiled as is. It's a real hunt. This is one hunt only. It's me a couple of hours out on this permission. And you guys join me, and it's my reality. Anyway, I still find cool stuff, and I'm definitely on the way to 10, which is important for 10 targets detecting, but it is time for a quick break. Guys, I'm just eating my muesli bar, and I've hit 10 targets, don't you worry. I'm happy with those three decimals. I'm going to go for a little while longer, though. That truck's cool. And where's that padlocky thing in the very beginning? Anyway, I've had to empty my pouch. It's getting a bit heavy. Started swinging, and this, just to show you how big these things are, you know those cans? You wind them here, wind, and it winds it open. Well, I found one. not cool. Okay, we keep going. This was a 58 target ID. I've got to hear it might be a spoon. Do you reckon? Oh, it's very large. That. Oh yeah, it is. Well, there you go. 58. Got ourselves a bit of cutlery. It could be silver plated. Let's have a look. Oh my goodness, look at the glass, thick glass here. Far out, I reckon I'm in a bit of a rubbishy area, let me tell you. I don't know, I'm just going to put this in the pouch and keep going. Now that I know that I've found 10 targets, and I've had my little muesli bar, bit of water, I think I might have maybe, what, I don't know, 10 more holes. Yep, and then call it. You know, my concentration's slowly waning. Okay, friends, it's gold colored doorknob. Wonder if it was gold plated. Wonder if it was someone so rich that had gold plated. You know how some people there's some people in the world that have gold plated toilets. Anyway, I'm beginning to lose it, aren't I? Anyway, what a nice little knob. Let's turn around soon, say goodbye. Because I've got my backpack on and I'm actually walking towards the car. I know I haven't said goodbye because I'm still swinging. And I haven't done a last dig. Three bars in the 80s. I've had to put some discrimination on because all the noise was doing my head in. There's a lot. Let's just dig three bars together. Let's see if I can do it. Ready? Can we get a lucky last three bars? Yeah! Yeah. You know, I detect a lot, so I don't need to go all day. I used to, when I first started detecting, sometimes I'd go, you know, till sundown. But these days, I like to limit, you know, don't go nuts. I don't like to go too nuts. My knees don't like it anyway. They can start to feel them. So, you know, gotta look after yourself. Can I end on something good? Oh, I can see a coin. It's only a 2 cent piece. Okay, it's a coin though. I've still got a little bit more to swing. And before we say goodbye, it's the best signal on the way back to the car without you. It's a bonnet of a car. It was 80. And if it was a whole car, that'd be cool. Anyway, all right, I'm gonna turn around. Say goodbye, it's time. Well, friends, that is a really good hunt. That is the reality of my detecting. I found 10 targets, and finding one pre-decimal coin is pretty cool. No silvers today, that's all right. Bit of, you know, variety, and so much fun. The roos are having a rest. It's time for me to get out of the sun as well and wash this stuff up. And let's see exactly what we found today. Well, friends, I think that coin spill was amazing because I did not realize how many pennies I actually found, and you can see the discoloration. So, you know, like where they're sort of often on top of each other, like, you know, there's those marks. Anyway, so many copper coins. You'd think a silver would turn up, but it didn't. Some half pennies and some actual pennies. This is a Jackson lock. It actually says Jackson's, very hard to see across there. Secure Everlock, it says Jackson markers. The riggers, and I know these is because I love padlocks and I found one previously. This is a Jackson's and look, similar. Do you want to see my favorite lock? My favorite one of these, it's a Union and it's actually got a key and opens. Yes, who doesn't love padlocks? Dig those big thumping hind target IDs, I reckon, and you might score one. This spoon says some stuff on it. I just can't make out exactly what it says. Oh, we can zoom in and someone will tell me what they think it is. I'm actually not going to keep this other stuff. Various bits and bobs, even the car. The car's pretty trash, to be honest. That's what you get in an old house's side. Thank you so much for joining me. If you haven't hit subscribe, please do. It helps my channel grow. Doesn't cost you a thing. I'll catch you next time. I appreciate you all and happy hunting.